Disturbing details surfacing in the domestic violence case of New York Giants kicker Josh Brown. New police documents have surfaced, and it paints a very disturbing image of the kicker based on his own writings, his own emails, letters, and journal stemming all the way back from 2013, in which he admits to abusing his ex-wife, admits to being a porn addict, admits to viewing himself as God and his ex-wife as a slave, and it's all very, very bad for Josh Brown. Now, here's the deal. He was arrested in Washington in 2015 on suspicion of domestic violence when he allegedly roughed up his wife. Here's the thing. Those charges were dropped, but now cops are releasing all of the documents associated with the case. Like I said, all these personal documents, including a journal and emails he sent to friends, a contract he signed with his wife, and they paint a scary picture of what happened behind closed doors with Josh Brown. According to these documents, he wrote things like, "I have physically, mentally, emotionally, and verbally been a repulsive man." And then he circled the words, quote, "I have abused my wife." In a letter he wrote to friends back in 2014, as part of counseling sessions with his ex, Brown basically said, quote, "I have been a liar for most of my life. I made selfish decisions to use and abuse women starting at the age of 7 to fill a void." He says he objectified women. His ability to connect emotionally to other people was zero. Then he says, "Because I never handled these underlying issues, I became an abuser and hurt my ex-wife physically, emotionally, and verbally. I viewed myself as God, basically, as she was my slave." He then acknowledged that he had an addiction to porn and used porn to kind of fill a void in his life. Now here's the twist, right? The New York Giants signed this guy to a 2-year contract worth up to $4 million just earlier this year after the domestic violence charges had been dropped and Josh, you know, he stated his innocence. The Giants stood behind Josh and said, "We support him because he wasn't convicted." The NFL had suspended him for one game, citing the personal conduct policy, but now all eyes are on the Giants. They want to see what the Giants are going to do. Now that they know this information, what are you going to do with Josh Brown? Are you going to let him continue to play on the team, or are you going to fire him? And did you guys know about these documents, that these existed when you signed under the contract earlier this year? All these questions, people want answers. We should find out, I'm guessing, by the end of the day, if not by the end of the week.